know him to be approved. Like we learned in today's Sunday school. Said, know the word of God, study it, meditate on it. While I was coming to choir rehearsals yesterday, that is the message was just entering my ears as I was thinking of, because I already called mommy and she said, this is what we are talking about. So it was the Spirit of God was ministering to me today. I started laughing, only me, I was just smiling. So when he talked, I'll talk back. I said, but oh, this thing, you know this thing not falling down. Are you the one doing it or the one doing it? I said, how do I go on this? I don't know what you are asked to do. Leave them. But it's no but. Say what you want to say and leave. Exactly. Praise God.
Exactly.
Focus. Know him. If you know God, that is, there are some things that comes to your understanding. It is very beautiful knowing God.
Yes.
Know him. Be approved of him. You don't need to wait for a man or a woman to tell you that you have been approved.
Yes.
You will know within you, say, because the Spirit searches our hearts. The Spirit of God inside of you will talk to the other spirit that you have to communicate.
Yes.
You will know that there is communication.
Yes, yes.
You have something in common. Praise God. Yes. Proverbs chapter 4, verse 26 and 27. Focus. Because when the divine settlement comes, probably God is planning 20 million for you and you are not focused. You start doing shopping. Zara. H&M, the other one. Before you know it, you say, what did I do with this money? How come? What did I do with this idea? I played with this, I threw it off. What did I do with this that God gave to me? So you have to be focused. Focus. Focus. Divine settlement. Focus.
Proverbs
4,
verse 26 to 27.
Yes, ma'am.
Ponder the path of thy feet, and let all thy ways be established. Turn not to the right hand, nor to the left. Remove thy foot from evil.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Ponder. That is meditate. Put it inside your heart. Be thinking about it. Be is like a goat when a goat eats a leaf. After he leaves that place, he will vomit the leaf again and start chewing it. And chewing it. Now, if the goat is not enjoying the flavor, the savour of the leaf, he will stay in one place and chewing. But he has swallowed the leaf for a very long time. But now he's not suffering it. All the bugs that he leaves, he's thinking, how God created this leaf sweet to me? We will not be trading there. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
That is what God wants you to do. He says, ponder the path of thy feet. Where you go. How you go. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
He said, and let thy ways be established. He said, turn not to the right, nor to the left. Remove thy feet from evil. Like we were talking, they said, natural man might not know what is evil.
Yeah.
You say, but when you are a child of God, like our daddy told us, you will know, say, because the Spirit of God will remind you. Say, this thing you just said is wrong. This place you are going is evil. Don't go there. You better come back. Even if you have done it, you say, it will remind you that thing you just did. You know it's evil. He now says something. Say, it's better for him to tell his wife the truth. The wife should be angry. And God will please with him. Than for him to lie to the wife and say the wife is happy, then God is not pleased with him. The most important one is God first. Remove your feet from evil. Praise the Lord. And the other Bible verse is Colossians chapter 2, verse 6 to 8. Colossians 2, verse 6 to 8. If you are there, and you.
Therefore, we see Christ Jesus, the Lord, so was in him. So, rooted and built up in him, as established in the faith, as ye have been taught, abounding therein in thanksgiving.
Amen. You have received Christ, you were born again. You have every right to live a beautiful life. Say, for as many that believe in you, to them you give power. He said, whosoever believe will not perish, but have eternal life.
Yes.
He said, he became poor that you might be rich.
Yes, yes,
he said, they that call upon the Lord shall be saved.
Yes.
You have every beautiful things in God. You have every right to be beautiful. You have every right to be rich. You have every right to live in health. He said, now that you have received the Christ, he said, walk ye in him. He said, but how? But be rooted and built up in him. Be rooted. When you plant a tree, in the ground. You might just plant a seed of beans in the ground, you put it in the ground, it's a seed. But after some time, it starts getting roots on the ground. You'll be looking at it, this beans is not a grow. This beans is not a grow, but something is happening on the ground. When the leaves spring up, before the leaves spring up, there's already a root at the down. Before your divine settlement spring up, let your roots be on the ground. Let it be rooted, not just on the root, but let it be rooted. That even if they come and they root from the ground, the roots will still remain. There are some trees, when you pull it up, the root will still be there. Just pour water on it to grow again. That is what the Bible says you should be. It says be rooted. How? In the word of God, not just in anything. You know, coming to church is not enough. But be rooted. And in being rooted in the word, you say, what will it make you? You say, it will be established in your faith. Because coming, especially like I always say, the easiest place to grow is in Bible study.
Yes.
Because it's talk I talk. Mm-hmm. And I say some things that are not right. You say, no, you don't want to have another
option.
You don't want to bring some other option. You put it together. And as you are going, you start thinking of it. Yeah. This thing that this is going to say, this thing that this is going to say. And as you go home, you will see the word will be coming back. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
It is the quickest and the best way to grow. Being rooted, being grounded. See? As you have been taught. If you are not taught anything, what will you be rooted in? If a child is being born, they say this child didn't need to grow. And every day you just pump water for the child, but they pump water. And you say, at least you cannot grow. How? How will the child grow? If the child is not being fed what it's supposed to be fed, so there's no possibility that the child will grow. Praise the Lord. You have been taught. He said, abounding in what you have been taught. Be taught. Let yourself be taught. Say, the Bible says, give yourself to a teacher. Nobody is an illiterate. Illiterate is of the mind. He said, I really changed. I'm not going to you. You are deceiving yourself.
Hallelujah.
It's your mind that is telling you that if you want to be taught, you will be taught.
Yeah.
You don't need to go to a classroom to learn. The word of God can make you a literate person. You will speak English more than those that went to Oxford, Cambridge University. I have seen it with my own eyes. Somebody that dropped out, don't speak English, became a youth president. When he was addressing the church, I was looking. I said, what time you take go to say? The word of God, speaking English like this with the word of God. This word of God is powerful. It can change a literate man. A literate man to a literate man. A poor man to a rich man. Depends on your application of it. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
The fourth point I wrote is functioning in wisdom. Praise the Lord. Let me take it very sharp. Functioning in wisdom. Jeremiah chapter 55 verse 15. Please, somebody else, Isaiah 33 verse 6. And Proverbs chapter 26, verse 3 to 6. Functioning in wisdom, because wisdom brings stability.
Yes.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Jeremiah 51, 15. And the other one is Isaiah 33, verse 6.
Jeremiah 51, 15.
Yes.
I read. He hath made the earth by his power, he hath established the world by his wisdom, and hath spread out the heaven by his understanding.
Hmm. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Did you see what God used?
Yes.
He made the earth by his power. Then he established the world by his wisdom. And he stretched out the heavens by his understanding. Three things. Number one is power. Number two is wisdom. Then number three is understanding. For as many that believe, to them he gave power. You believe, you will be given the power. Wisdom. He said, in all you're getting, get wisdom. You get it from the word of God by studying, by meditating, by making it part and parcel of you. And understanding is the application, how you apply it. We are to, he said, you are to walk in him. That means you are to do it the way God is doing it. If God is walking in this way, you walk in this way. If something is happening, you ask yourself, if God is in this situation, what will he do? Praise the Lord. Isaiah 33 verse 6. Let me quickly read because of time. It says, and wisdom and knowledge shall be the stability of thy times, and strength of salvation. The fear of the Lord is treasure.
Amen.
Praise the Lord.
Amen.
The fear of the Lord is your treasure.
Amen.
Wisdom and knowledge that bring the stability of the times. Today and Monday, God, how do I do this week?
Mm.
Huh? Father, I am 50 years old. Mm. When do I become wisdom and stability and knowledge shall be your stability? You have wisdom, you have the knowledge. You will be established, you will be stabilized, you will be settled.
Amen.
It comes with settlement, wisdom, knowledge, knowing. Not just ordinary knowing, but knowing the word of God and knowing God for who He really is. Knowledge. It brings stability. It brings settlement. There are things that children of God face. Those that do not know God, they die out of depression. Every day they go to hospital, they give them drugs for depression.
Mm.
Some they commit suicide. There are situations that you are facing right now. You think it's everybody that can face it.
Mm.
Even me that is coming here, and I can tell you my story, you will jump out of the window and say, my life. But I can stand, it's not because I'm strong, but because of God that I have inside of me. His word, I have decided to follow this.
Yes.
Because of the fear and the love that I have for God.
Yes.
If not, no, nobody will tell me to come to church. Mm. As I'm facing, I say, please, I beg, go and tell your God to do this thing first. But what are you saying?
Mm-hmm.
You talk here, you pass here.
Mm-hmm.
But I say no. At His own timing, God has a way of establishing.
Yes,
that is knowing God.
Mm-hmm.
That is applying wisdom. Know Him for who He really is. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
And we communicate.
Amen.
Praise the Lord. Proverbs chapter 26, verse 3 and 6. Proverbs 23, verse 3 to 6.
Verse 3 to 6 says, be not desirous of his dainties, for they are deceitful meat. Labor not to be rich, cease from thine own wisdom. Wilt thou set thine eyes upon that which is not? For riches certainly make themselves wings, they fly away as an eagle towards heaven. Eat thou not the bread of him that hath an evil eye, neither desire thou his dainty meat.
Hallelujah. Don't desire what the heathens have.
Mm.
Don't desire what the world people want. It's good. They have beautiful cars. They have everything that children of God are not. They don't even have. They don't know God. Sometimes I will ask myself, they say, the children of God, say they walk on in that way. They are like men. He said, but I have said that they are God. And one of you are children of most. Yet you die like men. Why? Because of lack of money. We are gods. When God wants to give birth, he will give birth to God.
Yeah.
If God's come, one boy go, one goat. If I go, one boy go, one fowl. When you see pussycat, you cannot see pussycat and back it. It is not possible. See, you see pussycat on the street, it's back in one world. You will first of all go and find out where the pussycat is from. Or you see a dog, you will be shouting meow, meow. You say, this one is a wish. This one is not an ordinary dog. Praise the Lord. The children of the world, they have what it takes. They have it. They have what their father will just allow them just to dance your image. Just to make you know that your God is not doing anything. That is a lie.
Amen.
The one you have, they desire it, but they will not tell you. They envy you from one side. The kind of peace you enjoy. There are some big men, they pay to sleep. They take drugs to sleep. You will just tell them, something is disturbing, but I don't want to make this disturbing you. I want to sleep. Before 2-3 minutes, you are already asleep. There are times I'm disturbed, I know the truth to sleep. If I'm disturbed, I cannot sleep, I'll start praying. Devil will not want you to pray. So if you start praying, you say, leave her, make sure she sleep. Instead of auto-pray, the daughter makes you sleep. Join me this way, my brother, let her sleep. This time, the sleep will come. That is just what I use. Sometimes if my mother asks you, just pray. I say, devil will not like you to pray.
Mm-hmm.
Pray. If you are praying, they will say, let them leave you. You know that when you pray, you cause trouble. You say, don't let them pray. Listen, you're going to prepare me now like a very happy man. See, I get here. Don't just go.
Hallelujah.
I can sleep. Unless I just decide to say, I don't want to sleep. Let me just go. See, I want to sleep and the devil is coming with different thoughts. I will just go on my knees. Father, in the name of Jesus. Inside my knee, I'll start nodding my head. I'm gone. Praise the Lord. He desires what you have. He cannot take it from you. So he will make them, he will give you pictures. You are poor. You are rich. You don't have anything. Look at you. Go look at this. Go look at brother that. Look at you are here. 10 years now, 14 years now, no level. No
shaking.
Hallelujah. But God is bigger than him.
Amen.
He is not bring stability. And if you point I wrote is living in righteousness. When you are living in righteousness, don't compromise. This part, even me as I was writing it down, I was like, this part, get as bill.
Yes.
Because don't compromise. This is your own day, so. How many hours are we doing? I do 5 hours. You know that I 4 hours to do it. But I'm for doing that. Now, lie, don't get small, lie. You don't get big, don't get the only beautiful, don't get the only ugly. You are said it. Just, I mean, like, clean this place, I clean that place, you just take the mop, you just turn it on. You squeeze it. Yasta. So that's why I told the staff about you. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Living in righteousness, do not compromise. You say, God, you know now, this thing has to be an issue. Me. That is why sometimes she will look at me and say, what's that for you? If you ask, you say, you do this one, I say, I've not done it all. You say, well, I say, now I say, give me no rich in the table.
Yeah.
So I go and share with you. Mm-hmm. You say, the pastor, I say, me, the pastor. I say, a pastor, what are you? You're a woman? That's a okay, no. Okay. I mean, I'm not the shark. I don't know what to
add. Yeah.
Just talking to me. He said, dear, I don't have anything to say. Okay, what are you? No, tell me another part of this. I see the facet. I don't get anything to talk now, madam. I tell you, say, I don't hear. I never go on because my hour not reach me.
Yeah.
If you give me a star hour, you say, no, that's the hour I don't ask me. But they have told me that you are using me here. Mm. Now, other people are doing this place for 8 hours.
Mm.
And I'm doing it for 6 hours. And you still pushing me no problem. I will not talk to her. I will not drag her. You just go and say, I say, no, that's it. I'm not pushing. This place or this place, I don't want to finish. I don't finish my work. That day I don't want to finish. My aura, I have one. My aura. She will just stand, but be looking at me. Then they die, eh? And someone tells me, eh? Then you talk. You don't talk. It is not because of the faithfulness of the holiness. I just believe that if I tell you the truth, you will know how to listen to me. You can't beat me. You must come to what you tell me, don't come to this place.
Yeah.
I will not come. I know that God will always make a problem. It might not be easy for us to understand, but it's not all doors that open that are doors of opportunity.
Yes.
And it's not all gift that comes that is gift from God.
Yes.
So when the compromise comes, it might be to challenge your faith.
Yeah.
The person that have been admiring you for a very long time, say, this person does not compromise. As he or she says she's a Christian.
Yes.
That is who she really is. So they will want to try you. So if you just fall, that is when you will know that they know that you are a Christian. You will say you're a Christian. At that day, I'm not doing you this thing, you don't fall. Brother, leave that thing. Sister, leave that. All of us are the same. And Europe will day. It is just to try you. And if you are able to stand, they will come back and tell you, please, I want to feel like you. You should be like me. How? There was somebody that was telling me, when I grow, I want to be like you. I said, I mean, when I grow, he said, I don't want to see at the top, but I want to be like you when I grow. I said, okay, when you grow, I better let me know. They actually admire what you have. They want to steal it from you. So what they will do is to make you compromise. It's not because they are bad. They are being pushed. They are manipulated. They give themselves to the devil to just come. So don't allow it. The money might be big sometimes. Very big. That you can use to establish yourself for life. You are settled. But the consequences is what we will talk about. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
What God is giving you is what money cannot buy.
Yeah.
It's bigger than what money can buy. Peace, you cannot buy it. The love of God in your heart, you cannot buy it. For you to be able to forgive who has offended you, it is not funny. You cannot buy the money.
Yes.
It takes that good inside of you.
Yeah.
There are some things you do to people. They say, after this thing you all happen, it is God that you have inside of you.
Yes.
The nature of God, the righteousness you have inside of you, don't compromise it. Big deal will come just to spite you. Know that when a big deal comes, a big deal of 10,000 comes. Know that the one that God is going to give to you is more than that. Devil will first of all show you the picture as he did to Jesus Christ. Stand on top of this hill. See the whole nation. I will give it to you. All everything you will be ruling. Just bow down and worship. But when Jesus Christ finally did what he was supposed to do, Now he has the whole world.
Yes.
Not just that small place he's going to show to you. Till tomorrow, men, me and you, who are talking about Jesus, who are still following and still believing in him. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Let us quickly look at the book of Isaiah 54:14 and Romans 5:17. Amen.
Amen. Isaiah 54 verse 14. I read. In right, verse 14, in righteousness shalt thou be established. Thou shalt be far from oppression, for thou shalt not fear, and from terror, for it shall not come near thee.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
In righteousness shalt thou be established. It is in righteousness that your divine settlement will come.
Amen.
In righteousness, knowing God, being in God, the life of God inside of you, do not compromise it. It is in righteousness that thou will be established. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
It is in righteousness. Romans 5:17.
Yes, it is.
Yes.
For if by one man's confession, rendered by one much more the rich receive abundance of grace, and of the gift of righteousness shall reign life by one.
Praise the Lord. If by Adam death reigned, men can die. Then, it's a day which receive abundance of grace and the gift of righteousness. Righteousness is a gift. It is a gift, not from anybody.
Yes.
Our righteousness is not our own. Our righteousness is that the future right before God. But the one we have is the righteousness of God, the nature of God. When Jesus Christ died, he gave us the ability to be righteous. As you say you are born again, as you confess your mouth, believe in your heart. Like our mommy rightly said, somebody said, when you want to use your tongue rightly, say, you should be conscious of using it. Not just that, your mouth and your heart should go together. They work together. Bible says, if thou shalt confess with your mouth and believe in your heart. Confess with your mouth, believe in your heart. You receive Jesus Christ. You are born again. You have a nature of God inside of you. Don't let anybody tell you that you're not righteous. The righteousness that Jesus Christ has is the same one you have. You are a righteous man, you are a righteous woman. You say, nobody is righteous. I am righteous. No drink is righteous. It is not my own.
Yes.
It's not that God gave to me.
Yes.
I didn't work for it.
Yes.
I didn't even ask for it. I was on my own. When Jesus Christ decided to say, I won't go die for you, I won't die. I'm not going to pass it down because he loved me.
Hallelujah.
After he died, he said, oh, yeah, take. I give you this. Accept me, you have righteousness. I'll throw it by battle. I said, okay, I love this sin. I accept. Mm. Our daddy said, we did not see Jesus. We were not there when he was killed, when he died. Yet we believed. Say, blessed are those that are not seen and yet believe. We are blessed. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Let no man tell you otherwise. You are righteous. 100% righteous.
Yes.
If Jesus Christ is 100% right, then that means you are 100% righteous.
Hallelujah.
You say we are joined here with Christ.
Mm-hmm.
Anything that Jesus Christ is sharing, we are sharing the 100%.
Yes.
If Jesus Christ is not going to sign check for anybody, if me, I'm not saying yes, that check cannot go sign
mm-hmm.
Because we are joined here. My grace are come to be operated. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Enjoy your righteousness. Don't let anybody settle.
Yes.
It will bring your settlement.
Amen.
Your righteousness. Acceptance. Be conscious of it. Just have it in your heart to be that I am righteous. It will bring your settlement. Your settlement comes from your being righteous. Accepting Jesus, you are righteous. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Like in the book of Genesis 13:7, where Jesus, where God settled Abraham and Jacob. Jacob was not born again. Abraham was not born again. They were seeing God. God will come and talk to them.
Yeah.
But right now, as we are, we have God living inside of us. We are more privileged. Sometimes some people will say, I wish I could just see God and make it talk to me. And yet, that was talking. They're very strict. You said, don't sin. You collect instantly. Don't go and speak to another person while you're doing instantly. Then you look back. But this time around, they have grace. People can even do what they like.
Hey.
Grace is sufficient. Jesus Christ will just be looking at it. These children, I don't know what you want to collect now. Praise the Lord.
Thank you, Jesus. Thank you for grace,
Lord. It is beautiful. It is time of grace.
Yes.
Enjoyable.
Yes.
Very, very sweet.
Thank
were enjoying Christianity. Now so many people paid for it. So many lives were lost. You know how many saw Kiwe, Apostle Paul, and you know how many, only him alone, do you know how many he slaughtered? Boko Haram, they keep when they are sacrificed for God. Out of ignorance. Many people died for it, but you and I, we are enjoying it now. Say, so we are living by grace. We are living by grace. Did you work for it? Do you know how you came? Can you maintain it? One thing is to have grace, and one thing is to maintain it.
Yes.
You can grow your grace. There are grace and there are grace.
Yeah.
No, John, everybody, we do not have the same grace. There are greater grace. The grace that this one has is not the grace that this one has. Yes, we have grace, but you grow your grace.
Yes.
Why would the word of God? Not with anything, not with magic, not be anything. It's in the word of God that you grow your grace. There are things that will happen for you. Somebody that is close to you will say, this thing will happen to me. It's not about grace. Another person will testify. Even if you didn't say it, don't just say this one is grace, and grace that is working for you.
Yeah.
My sister, your grace is great, eh? It is grace. Don't misuse it, don't abuse it. Praise the Lord. Genesis 13:7. Please, somebody there, you can quickly refer so that we will handle this. Genesis 13:7. Then, after you read the 7, you read 14:13.
Genesis 13:7 and 14. And there was a strife between the herdmen of Abram's cattle and the herdmen of Lot's cattle. And the Canaanites and the Perizzites dwelt then in the land.
Now please go to 14.
14. And the Lord said unto Abram, after that Lot was separated from him, lift up now thine eyes and look from the place where thou art, northward and southward and eastward and westward. Continue.
Yes, 17.
For all the land which thou seest, to thee will I give it, and to thy seed forever. And I will make thy seed as the dust of the earth, so that if a man can number the dust of the earth, then shall thy seed also be numbered. Arise, walk through the land in the length of it and in the breadth of it, for I will give it unto thee. Amen.
You know, from the very beginning, I asked, I said, anybody want trouble? They said, nobody feel as bad. They said, nobody want trouble. And I told us in the book of John chapter 5, verse 5, there are times the angel of God will stir up the trouble.
Yeah.
He will stir up the water to the trouble. That was exactly what happened now in verse 7.
Yes.
The water was troubled. There was a strife between Lot and Abraham. And imagine Lot, small boy. Abraham took from the other and said, follow me, uncle. Feeding him, doing everything. He now became rich. He now started rubbing shoulder with his uncle. God saw everything. Abraham was a very humble man. See, they fought. After they now fought, you know what happened next? Abraham said, choose. The land is before you, anywhere you want to go. Then he chose the side that was greener pasture. Everywhere was green. He said, my sheep, they will feed fish again. Abraham will suffer. I want to increase with a green pass. And this side, I will see where the sheep will go. Only if he was disappointed, he might not know that he just lost out.
Yeah.
Success of somebody might be whoever you are linked to. You might be successful. It might be that it is who you are linked to that is making you success. And when you spit the person on the face, there is a cut off of the flow of the success.
Exactly.
Because Lot didn't enjoy everything he was enjoying again. Out to the extent that he had to run away from his home.
Yeah.
He even had to commit, I don't know how to call that one. His daughter was now sleeping with him. But at the beginning, when he started, he now felt he was like a big boy. What if he gets when I don't get? I beg. I don't know who tracked this, the service of which level. But he was disappointed. There are some things that God will trouble. God will shake.
Yeah.
Not because he hates you, but he wants to push that thing away from you.
Yeah, exactly. Mm-hmm.
And when you push it away, it will open your eyes to another new level.
Yes.
For God to settle you this year, there are some things he will trouble and push away. Don't be afraid. Let the trouble come. Stand. He said he will give you trouble, he will give you a way of escape. Let it come from the north. Let the devil throw it out, let it throw it. He said, God, When the evil one rises up against us like a flood, the Holy Ghost will raise a standard against him. And the devil is coming up, staring me, doing everything he wants to do. It is for your good. Because at the end, God will tell you, go this side, go this side, go this side. I'll give you everything. It is your evil, the land will not stay safe. Even after the land of your enemies, he will give it to you. This year, at the very settlement, even the inheritance of those that are fighting against you, he will take it. It is a year of
mercy.
Let them fight. Let them throw their bomb. Missile, no problem. And they are throwing it. There's a standard that is raised against them.
Against them, yes.
At the end, God will tell you, just go and collect everything that
you Amen.
You start collecting it.
Amen.
Like in a situation where the three lepers had to come and tell the other people, say, this land is where we are. Now there are people. They say, let us go and fight for food. Their footstep became a sound of an army. Army troop. The people ran away from their camp.
Mm.
They had to go and say, King, oh, come, oh. This is all food, but there's a one around this country. People don't run from more food full every year. And the prophecy has already been declared.
Yeah.
And by this time tomorrow,
oh,
a bag of fries will be selling this for 1 euro. Some people will say, ah, you want to sell a bag of fries for 1 euro.
Mm.
He said, no, not that they will be selling it for 50 cents. He said, this is Spaniard. Leave that thing. He said, very soon, those things that Papa will not do, they will start doing. He said, you know what happened, you know what this coming here. Do not that. A prophecy has been declared that it's our year of the grand settlement.
Yes.
Do not shake, do not move.
Amen.
God is going to send an army, the son of an army, to the camp of the enemy.
Amen.
They will start running when no one is pursuing them.
Amen.
All you need to do is to step into your inheritance.
Amen.
Collect it and be settled.
Amen.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
God is seriously working on our case.
Amen.
When a prophecy is made, it depends on how you run with it. It has been declared our year of settlement.
Amen.
Settlement, divine establishment. And no matter what, we will be settled on every side.
Amen.
On every side, we will be settled.
Amen.
Genesis chapter 31, please. Verse 11 and 12. Genesis 31, verse 11 and 12.
Verse 11.
Yes, Genesis chapter
31, verse 11 and 12. I read. And the angel of God spake unto me in a dream, saying, Jacob, I said, here am I. And he said, lift up now thine eyes and see. All the rams which leap upon the cattle are ring straight, speckled and grizzled. For I have seen all that Laban, or all that Laban doeth unto thee. Hallelujah. 29. It is in the power of my hand to do you hurt, but the God of your father spake unto me yesternight, saying, take thou heed that thou speak not to Jacob, either good or bad.
Hallelujah.
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 Amen.
Did you hear what Mama just read? Did you hear what Mama just read? That's verse 11 and 12. It is an agreement. You have had an agreement, you have done a business deal. You say this is how you are going to be settled. At the end of it all, they want to do you good. God comes to you in a dream. God comes to a man of God in a revelation and said, this is our year of divine settlement. And he declares the word. And the devil said, there is no way you will be settled. Instead of you to be settled, I will fight you 2 times a day. I have to run. I have to escape. I have to pray. I have to fast. I have to stand on my feet. Then on my standing, on my fasting, on my praying, on my waiting, by determination, my focus, and my belief, God comes and goes to the enemy camp and said, if you touch this
king,
if you touch this man, what I will do to you in your entire generation, you will never forget it. No matter what the enemy has planned, God is sending his army of war to
Amen.
Them. To remind them that you are his child.
Amen.
He has already promised that he will send you all the
yes.
settlement.
Yes.
Everything that you touch, he said, even if they have planned and said, we are going to be giving you Byron. That Byron will be yours.
Yes.
Black Byron. Everything will be black Byron. Why? Because this is for your family. Then when the devil now decides to say, no, black Byron is working for this man, he's working for this woman, I will turn you to blue. God will go to them. In their dreams, in their revelation, in their camp, in their homes. You don't need to fight much. For me, this year, The fighting has already begun. The day the word was declared, the verse of the word, that was the day the fighting was done. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Because God heard, He is not
dead. Yes.
Say, believe in the Lord God. You will be established. In His prophets. And you will prosper.
Amen.
The prophet said it is the divine settlement. And you believe.
Yes.
There's no way you will not prosper in your
Amen.
World. If the devil stands and says the enemy stands, any word, any man, any voice and say, no, we will not allow it. Then they are in trouble. Because God is already involved.
Amen.
Because you believe in the prophet.
Yes.
Because you believe in God.
Amen.
You will be established.
Amen.
And you will prosper.
Amen.
In all that you do.
Yes.
He said, ponder on your feet. On your going, in your coming.
Yes.
Do not compromise. Live in righteousness. Believe in me. Focus. I am going to bless you. I am going to establish you. I am going to strengthen you. Hallelujah. 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 Please, let's just rise on our feet at this moment. I need to bless the name of the Lord.
Hallelujah.